sometimes.
Good day, folks. We are here under very tragic circumstances to do the service of our brother, Josiah. You all are specially invited guests, so you all are were very close to him. And of course, that is picture here. It looks like his wedding picture, if I'm not mistaken. We thank God for him. So now, let's have this service for him as we send him off. If you are able, please stand. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. His favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes with the morning. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted." Let's continue in prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, who loves us with an everlasting love and can turn the shadow of death into the light of a new day, help us now to wait upon thee with penitent and believing hearts, that as we hear the words of eternal life, we may have hope and be lifted above our present darkness and distress into the light and peace of thy presence. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. We sing as we begin. Amazing grace. God's grace is so amazing that with him we can do anything, and we could bear all grace, everything. All right, amazing grace. Are we going to get any music out of it? Okay, thanks. Okay, let's not put them on any stress. We're already on so much stress. We can sing this on our own, right? Let's go.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that tore my heart to fear, and grace my fear relieved. Our precious did that grace appear. The hour I first believed, through many dangers, toils and snares, I have already come. is grace that brought me saved thus far, and grace will lead me home. The Lord has promised good to me. This word by whom seek yours, God will my shield and portion be. As long as life endures, what ties I owe you and what love about less air, less shall echo through the realm above, when time shall be no more, when we and yet 10,000 years bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first began. Amen. You may have your seats. Let's come to God in prayer. Let's pray. Father, you are merciful and you are kind, you are caring. At this time, O God, we pray that you will cleanse us, O Father, from all of our guilt that is upon our consciences. Cleanse us, O Father, so that we can continue being in your presence. We pray this prayer in your name, O Lord Jesus. Amen. At this time, we'll invite any member of who are here to come and give us a few words. You will know who you are, and you know, thanks.
Okay, good morning, everyone. My name is Sham Nibar. I am married to Devika's sister. I've known Josiah for over 10 years. My first impression, well, first time, you know, meeting Josiah, you know, the first thing that kind of stood out to me was how he liked to, you know, go to the beach. So, you know, anytime you want to go beach, you just say, "Hey, Josiah, we go beach this weekend now?" And he would say, "Yeah, man, we leave at 6 in the morning." And, you know, Josiah, he was really a fun-loving guy, you know, very, very respectable, you know. You could tell by, you know, his parents, you know, they would always be so proud of him, you know, and they would always talk so greatly about him. One of the more defining moments between me and Josiah was when I was getting married. It's a old tradition with, you know, Hindus, where the old people would tell you, you know, if you're staying in a house, don't stay by yourself when you're getting married, you know. So I asked Josiah, I said, "Well, Josiah, you know, I need somebody to stay with me before the wedding." So Josiah was like, "Yeah, no problem, you know, I'll stay with you. That's not a problem." So, you know, it was a few days before the wedding, so Josiah stayed with me, you know, during that time. And, you know, we lime, you know, we watch TV, you know, we talk and that kind of thing. And Well, I never had a brother, so it was, you know, at that point in time then, you know, that I kind of formed a bond with Josiah, and he was like a brother to me, you know. I never had a brother, and he was like the brother that I never had then, right? On my wedding day, again, another tradition is the groom isn't supposed to walk to the car. Somebody's supposed to carry you to the car, so physically pick you up and carry you. So initially, I had organized with one of my uncles to do it. But being the size that I am, it was a bit difficult for him to carry me. So Josiah was there, so Josiah volunteered. So, you know, Josiah and my uncle picked me up and carried me to the wedding car. You know, Josiah rode to the wedding with me, you know. And, Josiah was actually on the bride's side because, remember, he's, at that time, he was the vicar's boyfriend. But, you know, he basically switched sides to come and help me out, you know, and that's just the kind of guy he is. No matter what, then, you know, he would always try to help you, you know. Like if, you know, me and my wife, you know, we decided that we want to do a little charity work or something, you know, make something, give to our family, we would always, like, you know, if we don't know who to give it to, we would always ask Josiah, like, Josiah, you know, do you know anybody who needs this? And Josiah is a guy, he would be like, yeah, you know, I could organize, I could get somebody, a family, you know. He always knew then, you know, that anybody that he could help, he would always try to help them, no matter what. Even his students, anything, you know, he could do for his students, because, I mean, well, everybody knows he's a teacher. Anything he could have done for his students, he would have done it for his students. All right? And another thing with Josiah, whether it is his birthday, you know, Christmas, anything, you know, if you give Josiah a gift, no matter how small that gift was, Josiah would always be so appreciative of it, you know. And I mean, you could actually feel that appreciation from Josiah. That's just the kind of guy he was, you know. And in other, you know, times, you know, me and Josiah, you know, anytime we meet up, we would always talk, you know. Any kind of advice I would have wanted with regards to, like, fitness training, that kind of thing, I could always come to Josiah and say, hey, Joe, you know, I want to find out something. And Josiah would always have an answer for me. If he didn't have an answer, you know, we would be sitting down, we would Google, you know. But Josiah was just a very knowledgeable guy, and he was never, you know, stingy with his knowledge. He would always share his knowledge with you, you know. Anything you ask him, he would always try to help you. Now, when my daughter was born, our daughter was born, we started seeing Josiah a lot more often, you know. Josiah and Devika would come, you know, by us, you know, almost every day, you know, they come in to play with our daughter, you know. And our daughter just developed a great bond with Josiah, you know. You know, they would always, when he comes, you know, she would hug him up, you know, they would be taking pictures, playing, all kind of thing, you know. And even up to now, if we ask our daughter, you know, who is your favorite? She would always tell us Uncle Joe, you know. And at this point in time, we don't know how to break the news to her, you know. She doesn't know. She's a very young child, and we don't know how to break the news for her. But for all intents and purposes, right now, her favorite is Uncle Joe. Right? And in closing, I just want to say, Josiah was such a nice guy, you know. He was always helpful. And, I mean, he wasn't our blood relative, but he was like family to us. And we love him so much, and we will just miss him. And, I mean, I don't know. I don't have the words to say it, but Josiah, we love you. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Navita Nibar, Josiah's sister, not Devika's sister. I've known Joe for about 10 and a half years. From the time my sister decided to introduce him to us, we knew him as a teacher to the back of our house. He taught in the Esperanza Presbyterian School for a long time, and we knew him as a teacher from this school. So it's only when she brought him home and introduced him as her boyfriend, you know, we started getting to know him. Joe is always a kind, considerate, and respectful person, always. He was such a positive and calm person that he could make anyone feel comfortable when around him. You could always sense that he was such a genuine person. I've always loved how he smiled. When he smiled, he would chuckle. His whole face would just light up. you know, we're actually looking at pictures for the last week or two, you know, over and over, and that's all we're seeing, you know, his face is so bright with his smiles. He loved to make jokes, talking about, you know, a wide number of topics, current affairs. We always, you know, we're talking to the point, sometimes we're arguing a point because somebody must be right. He loved family activities like going fishing down the islands with our cousins, going to Tobago, swimming at Shallows Beach was one of his favorites. We made some wonderful memories in Tobago. I remember a time some years ago, all of us, when I say all of us, my brothers and sister and mommy and daddy, we went to Tobago and we stayed in my cousin Sunil's apartment. And Sunil let us stay up all night in the pool swimming, Josiah and Vanna. Shivana teaching us swimming techniques all night, making noise, you know, waking up all the other guests in the apartment. You know, he really tried to teach Sham to swim confidently, he really tried. The very next day too, Joe took me out swimming at Shallows, the furthest I've ever gone. I didn't even realize how far I was, so I looked around. But he tried to keep me as safe and as calm as possible. When my daughter was a year old, we went back to Tobago again with my parents and Joe and Shivana. It was such an unforgettable trip. We talk about it all the time. Joe insisted we go beach hopping, where we would drive to a bunch of beautiful beaches and just come out and bathe in all of them. I remember saying, so we're not gonna change. And he was like, no, why? We have to swim again. It doesn't make sense. We were looking forward to the pandemic ending so that we could go back to Tobago. I'm sure that everyone here knows how Joe loves to eat pork. And that's one thing I would always harass him about all the time. His face would light up when you mentioned pork, or you send him a picture of something on Facebook. I remember a few months ago when Quankep posted on Facebook that they were moving from Grand Bazaar to buy a pre-sal flyover. And I messaged Joe and I said, oh my God, all your dreams are coming true, Joe. And he would just laugh and laugh. And I don't know if he ever got to go to visit them. Since I've known Joe, he has been a teacher. Joe has always been so passionate about teaching and helping his students. He would always say he wished he could help them more. When he saw someone struggling, he would always try to make an effort to help. I remember once I asked him if I could make party bags for his class, and he could not stop thanking me for months for thinking of his students. Since the pandemic started, he would always worry about his students. He would always talk about who had devices, who didn't have internet access. And he said, you know, if I had money, I would pay for everything for everybody. But all jokes aside, for years, I've always admired how his family loved him and how he displayed love. When his mother and father spoke about him, they would beam with pride. His dad always said he was the perfect son, and his mother and siblings were always so proud of him, as he was of them. We were also truly fortunate to have him join our family. To this day, I admire his unwavering love for God, his family, and his love for my sister. I know that Shivana and Joe were truly happy and unconditionally loved each other. Even long before Joe and my sister got married, he was always loving, kind, and respectful. Towards our family, my parents, my husband and my daughter, my brothers and their families, and even towards our uncles, aunts, and cousins, and we have a lot. Joe and Shivana loved to spend time with their nieces and nephews, and the children always had fun with them, always taking pictures, taking them to the, you know, to like Chuck E. Cheese. Over the years, Josiah has been an integral part of our family. In Joe, my parents got another son and we got a brother. For both my husband and I, he has always been there for us, supporting us through every step of our lives, from dating to getting engaged, setting up our house, getting married and becoming parents. Joe was always there by our side. To this day, our daughter really, as Sham said, she says Uncle Joe is her favorite, and so he loved to hear that. Today, as we gather here to say our final goodbye to such an amazing person, I want to take this time to pray for our brother Josiah. I pray that God blesses and guides him in this new journey. I pray that God also blesses our families and all his loved ones with strength, courage, and peace during and after this time. This morning, just before I came, I received a call from my best friend, Diane Pilgrim, who's not here. But she wanted me to specifically mention that, you know, she had so much fun spending time with Shivana and Josiah for our wedding. And then she got really sick a while after. And she said she was so grateful that they came and Josiah took time off to come and visit her in the hospital. And she wanted to say how he was such a sweetheart, and I promised her I would say it, that yes, you know, she said she loved them, just, you know, just as her own brothers and sisters. And she wanted me to mention that. Yeah, thank you.
Hi, morning everyone. We must give God thanks in all things. Whenever Josiah had to speak, that would always be his first line. And we are here this morning to give thanks for an angel who walked with us 40 years and 17 days. I couldn't sit to write anything because there's so many, many things that I could say about Josiah. First of all, Josiah was quite accomplished, and if you and his academic accomplishments didn't really mean much to him, because Josiah was an average Joe. Josiah accomplished as far as a master degree, and his personality was such that it didn't affect his ego or anything like that. Josiah would talk to anybody, anytime, anyhow, whether you be in a suit or in a bus pants, Josiah would give the same respect. Another thing that a trademark of Josiah is money. Money didn't mean anything to Josiah. What meant everything to him was love, understanding, and being a compassionate person. As the younger brother, Josiah didn't care for anything much except for the relationship that we had, especially with his family. I remember Josiah would have a new sneakers, and I would go run in the room, take out the sneakers, go play cricket. It would be muddied. And I know in my head, you know, I said, Joey, go quarrel, thing. And in the morning, the sneakers clean and wash, and Josiah never say a word. I would use all of Josiah's clothes that he put away, and he wear for a special day. The boy never quarrel, he never say anything. I know that parents really say that they have a favorite, which could probably be true, but Josiah was a favorite to everybody. I am on all sides of the families. He was a son to everybody. I mean, that was my mother and father's spoiled child. As my mommy was saying a couple days ago, up until Josiah married, them iron the boy clothes. Yeah, they probably iron his wedding clothes too. And that just goes to show the kind of relationship and the kind of love that they had for each other. With respect to church, there isn't a person who I spoke to who had any doubts about Josiah's love for church. Church was first and foremost in everything. Regardless of whatever went on, you know, the love for the Lord was always there. I just try to reflect. I have so many thoughts that are running through my mind that I can't identify one or two, but all I just want to say is that, you know, Josiah is a gem of a person. Because for the 40 years and 17 days that he was with us, his legacy, his good deeds, his actions, going to live on for another 40 years comfortably. I am sure in years to come, I'm still going to hear what Josiah did. I have made many friends at secondary school because Sir Josiah taught them. And the impact that Josiah had with these children, it still lives on until this day. And it's very rare to find somebody who is so genuine and nice. And Josiah had a heart made of gold. If he could have given anyone the world, he would have. So, I mean, Joe, right now, it's not goodbye, but we're going to see you soon. And when Josiah passed, the first thought that ran through my mind was Daddy carried Joey with him, because we lost our dad a few days earlier. and Daddy carried Joey with him. And those of you who know the two, you know, two of them can't saddle for anything. So, but the only thing that they could have agreed on was the love that they have for the family. And one thing that I say to comfort myself is that in Josiah's final moments, he had a moment of clarity. And in that moment of clarity, he saw what needed to be done and why it needed to be done. And Josiah slipped away so peacefully. The moments after, Josiah looked like an angel. Josiah looked like his best self. So, Joe, I know you are up there looking down at us, or probably next to us right now. I know you are preparing a place for us. Thank you for everything that you have done. You have impacted on so many lives. The world is a better place because you were here. And as we say goodbye to your physical body today, your love, your actions, your deeds, your thoughts, your everything has made this world a better place. Thank you.
Good morning. I just have a little poem here, and I wrote a letter to him, so I'll read my poem first. The poem says, "No farewell words were spoken, no time to say goodbye. You were gone before we knew it." And only God knows why. Our hearts still ache in sadness, and secret tears still flow. What is meant to lose you, no one will ever know. To my loving husband, Josiah, no words cannot express or can express how heartbroken I am that you are gone. You were kind, hardworking, caring, strong-minded, when necessary, stern. You were a fighter, and in the end, you always won. If you all knew him, you know that you could never win a fight if Josiah is there. In that same light, I will fight. I will fight for the things in this life that my heart desires. I will fight for your hard work and your achievements and what you believe in. I want to make you proud. I know you will be my guardian angel. And you will ensure that we are all okay. Oh, how I wish I could see that confident smile on your face. But I know that you are smiling where you are, with your Lord. I would give anything just to hear you say one more time, "Devika, don't worry, everything is going to be okay." I always feel better when you say that. I am taking it that you are saying it right now, so I am comforted by it. I will carry you always with me. I love you with all my heart. Rest in peace. Thank you.
We will now have a portion of scripture read for us. There isn't much more you can say what I already heard, you know. This person was such a loving person. We'll have the scripture reading right now, because it will also help us who are still alive. Chapter 9, verses 24 to 27.
First Corinthians 9, reading from verses 24 to 27. Let us listen to God's word. "Do you not know that in a race the runners all compete, but only one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may win it. Athletes exercise self-control in all things. They do it to receive a perishable wreath, but we are an imperishable one. So I do not run aimlessly, nor do I box as though beating the air, but I punish my body and enslave it, so that after proclaiming to others, I myself should not be disqualified. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen.
Friends, let's sing again. Blessed Assurance. If you are able, please stand. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine.
The fortress of glory divine, heir of salvation, presence of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song. Praise in my
have your seats. Let's, as you said, let's come to God in prayer. Father, you are God. It is you who created us. And it is you, God, we depend upon to help us during this time of bereavement. To this end, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you, Lord, our strength and redeemer. Amen. Scripture tells us in Ecclesiastes, naked a man comes from his mother's womb, and as he came, so he departs. He takes nothing from his labor that he can carry in his hand. And that is so true for all who have departed. Whatever we leave, when we leave this life, we carry nothing with us other than the things that we have done that are stored in heaven. Look at how beautiful, handsome, in fact, I should say, Josiah looking there. I remember him standing next to our next beautiful person. She's sitting here. He has left us. She is here. But what we need to recognize is simply this. One day we will all die. And the way how Josiah lived his life, I don't have to repeat all those things that are beautiful things that are said about him. Personally, I know what was said is how he was. And that's so important for us. Because Josiah always has a smile when he's speaking with you. Always have thinking about others. Even just to call me and tell me about if you could give out more stuff, hampers and so forth, of people who are in need and so forth. So he always look outside of himself to help others. I know, Devika, you will surely miss him. Because when we spoke together, the three of us, I recognize that there was a bond between both of you all. How many years? No, I can't remember. It had to be a lot of years that you all were always together. And we also thank God that you all decided you're going to tidy knot, as we say in marriage, and become husband and wife. All right, but I think you all were already tied in a knot a lot longer than when you actually officially did it on that day when you all were married before Almighty God. So we always need to give God thanks. We all need to give God thanks for Josiah in this situation, because while I hear he might have been a favorite, right? I also know that parents, you will love all your children. Somebody doesn't be no favorite. It's just who less hardened than the next one, right? And things like that. But we are people who live in relationships. And Josiah showed that. He showed the qualities of how to live in relationships. While he was 40 years plus, I think it was 17 days I'm hearing, right? Up to the date. Can you tell me the hour too? I'm sure if you could walk it back from mom, right? But this is how it is. 40 years and he left. But friends, don't forget where he is now. And don't forget his Lord, right? Jesus Christ came into the world. How long, what was his age when he left? He was a young man, right? When he gave his life for the forgiveness of sins of all of us. So when we look at it, I'm asking God, I hear it in the poem, why God took him. But, you know, the other way we have to look at, God gave him to us for all these years that he has been with us. And he blessed us with Josiah, his relationships with everybody, school children, adults, everybody else. I heard somebody even was, come like the best man. How does it be the little boy who does go with the person when they're going to get married in the Hindu tradition? Right, sorry. All right, he come like that. I said, wait, boy, look up. He's so big in taking that part, right? But that's the sort of person he was, right? Our Lord and Savior is also that type of person, always loving, always caring, always healing people, helping people, and so forth, right? Josiah displayed those qualities, and he was with us how long? 40 years plus, right? So we thank God for this privilege that we had to be with this human being, to be with a son, to be with your husband, right? For all these years. Now, how did he look? That scripture was read for us today. It showed us clearly, right? That, better said, yeah, everyone who competes in the games goes in the strict training. They do it to get a crown that will not last. But we do it to get a crown that will last forever. And this is the difference with Josiah, my friend. This is the difference that he belonged to God. Because here is St. Paul. Don't worry, just concentrate, you'll listen to it. Because this is the gospel, actually, right? The good news of Jesus Christ. He did it, right? St. Paul was an evangelist. We all know him. Most of the New Testament was written by him, right? And St. Paul showed that as we live our lives, we don't live it for a temporary reason while we are only living, right? We live it for a crown that will last forever. And this is what I'm trying to let you all know that. Well, Josiah exemplified a lot of good things. And he received his Lord and Savior. He received Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. You see, friends, while many of people believe in different beliefs, what will happen after their life come to an end, right? But Josiah believed what God said, right? Through his son, Christ Jesus, right? Whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And Devika, you on your own, or your part, and mom and children and everybody else who are here, we have to appreciate that God sent his son to die for the sins of the world. And Josiah believed in him, right? So therefore, when he believed in him, that he will never die. You know, people have different beliefs, as I said, without going into the examples of these beliefs. But he believed, and God himself said,
He will be with him forever, for eternity. Right? The best I could tell you, Devika, without going to any lengthy sort of sermon, you are privileged, mom also, and everybody else, right? You are privileged to have this person living with you all. We don't know how long. None of us know how long this life is going to be in this earthly life, right? We will die. But I know all of us here, where do we want to go when we die? I want to go to heaven, right? And we could say, because God said it, it will be so. And what did he say? He will live forever in eternity, right? Jesus himself told us, right? I go to prepare a place for you, and I will come back to take you to be where I am. So you see, friends, Josiah is another scripture I just let you know, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord, right? And the Lord is the Son of God, right? Who is sitting on the right hand of God the Father. And there is where Josiah is now. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Devika, be thankful and happy for the time you spent with him, right? I talk about before marriage, right? All them years, also do all kind of different things. I ask them at the time, so it doesn't quarrel and thing. You know, Right, this sort of way, right? But you know, always had a little dispute, a little issue and whatnot. I heard Jesse saying about taking the boy's shoe and going and doing all kind of thing. And Josiah don't say quarrel or anything. He had a special quality about him that most of us could emulate, could follow. Right? So be thankful and grateful that you all were blessed to have a person like this living in your presence while he was here. Again, like how Jesus Christ came, you remember? He came, a baby, right? Now it's Christmas season, right? And then when he reached a young man, he left and went back to heaven, right? Don't forget these things. So let us be thankful and grateful for God given, granting to us Josiah to be part of our life. Remember him, he won't forget you all. And you want to be with him again? You will be, but there's a contingency on that. Devika, without letting you know, you have to believe in his son. And when his son comes again, he calls everybody, like Josiah, physical body now, will rise from the grave, be transformed or glorified, and go up to be with him. Mom, I know this is a double blow for you. Right, I heard someone saying you maybe took him to be with him, right? Your husband, right? Ralph. But this is the reality. We all want to go to heaven. To reach the heaven, we will die and then go. The only time we will not die is when Jesus, if he returns again while we are still living. Right? You all know these things. I'm just touching it on for you all, right? While we are still living, if he returns, all who are living, their bodies will be transformed, because this body cannot go to heaven. This body is not immortal, it's mortal, right? And this body will be transformed and taken, right? So we're going up, when he comes again the second time, and you hear that trumpet, whether you're living or dead, you're going up with him, physically. But spiritually, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. All right? Friends, in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, amen. So,
good morning, everyone. I am Josiah's youngest aunt, Shirian. My sister Jane is his eldest. I just want to take 2 minutes to let you know that when Josiah was born, it was great rejoicing in our family. The old people you see in there is my parents, Joseph and Sylvia, and Josiah led a life of royalty from a baby. And I mean a life of royalty. He was special to everybody, especially my sister Jane, that's her eyeball. Anything she does is for Josiah. Even when he got involved with Devika and he came and he told me, she didn't even know. I went and I was looking at her and whatever, and I said, okay, Josiah. I said, it's your choice, because Auntie Jane wants to make sure everything is perfect for him. And Josiah was our everything on the Pulwarty side of family. He was our everything. Up to the ending, anything Josiah wants, he just have to say he wants it and he gets it. We were very privileged to have him. He was an angel in our lives. And we are very privileged that he was a part of our lives. It's going to be difficult. He was my everything also. And the love he had for his aunts was beyond measure. And the love his aunts had for him is beyond measure. Our second sister, Avis, she has Alzheimer's. She can't recognize even her husband and her sons. Her son could testify to that. But once she sees Josiah, she will say, Joey, that's the only person she recognizes. The cousins, they are close. They live like brothers and sisters, not like cousins. And I know deep down in my heart, he is with the angels. I feel it. I know it. It's going to be a little difficult. His physical being isn't here. But growing up, he spent time with his grandparents, Joseph and Sylvia Pulwarty. He spent time with his aunts. We used to joke about it. And, you know, Madri being a new mother and stuff like that. My father made sure there was somebody looking at Josiah 24 hours a day. Never took your eyes off him or else he wouldn't get a buff. So, Josiah, we love you. We know you are with the angels. God bless you. May you have eternal and peaceful rest in his kingdom. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sherianne. Let's come to God in prayer as we now kind of wrap up this part of the service, right? And following this, you know, we'll have the only 10 persons will be allowed here, as right afterwards, right? You'll know who you are, the 10 persons. All right, let us come to God in prayer. Father, we have lost one of our own, Josiah Pulwarty. But God, he belongs to you. We know that. For the qualities he displayed, for the qualities that you placed into him, and which you would like all of us to display. Father, this time we lift up the family who are in mourning, as the mother, Mrs. Pulwarty, his wife, who will surely miss him, oh God, his sister, his brother, all his family and friends who are here at this time, oh God, we lift them up before you. Lord, embrace them. Let them know that you are God and we are all with you, and none of us who are in you through your Son, Christ Jesus, will ever be lost. Bless us, bless them, O God. Minister to their needs at this time. Place in your hearts that Josiah is in a far better place than now, than where he was before, although he was so loving and caring and kind where he was before. Bless them, O Father. Embrace them, O God. Grant to them your Holy Spirit to minister to their needs, to their what all the things that are affecting them at this time in their lives. We pray this prayer in your name, O Lord Jesus, as we now all join together and pray in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Friends, as I said, now we will, you know, we will only have 10 persons here now. As those who are not part of the 10, thank you for coming and supporting the family.
One court requires, Lord, who may enter your temple? Who may worship on Zion, your sacred hill? those who obey God in everything. I'm reading Psalm 15, and it is entitled, What God Requires. Lord, who may enter your temple? Who may worship on Zion, your sacred hill? Those who obey God in everything and always do what is right, whose words are true and sincere, and who do not slander others. They do no wrong to their friends, nor spread rumors about their neighbors. They despise those whom God rejects, but honor those who obey the Lord. They always do what they promise, no matter how much it may cost. They make loans without charging interest and cannot be bribed to testify against the innocent.
There is only one thing that you must do. Okay, listen as we all sing this song for you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, have a happy birthday. Happy birthday, happy birthday, have a happy birthday. Today, there is only one thing that you must do. Today, there is only one thing that you must do. Okay, listen as we all sing this song for you. Happy birthday, happy birthday.
In the secret place of the Most High, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him I will trust. In the secret place of the Most
All right, I got it, thanks. Friends, let us hear the words of eternal life once again. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble, therefore we will not fear. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. And again, I want to repeat the scripture again that was said to us a little earlier. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Let us continue in prayer. Let us pray. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear him. For he knows our frame. He remembers that we are dust. As for man, his days are like grass. He flourishes like a flower of the field, for the wind passes over it, and it is gone, and its place knows it no more. But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon those who fear him, and his righteousness, the children's righteousness. Friends, I'm going to do the final committal at this time. Would you all like to put the flowers before or after? All right, well then let me do it and then we'll sing, right? We sing the song in a sweet by and by. All right, Sherian, you'll help me with this one, please. Guy will be up there now, okay? I'll start. There's a land that is fairer than thee.
Thank you.
the Most High shall abide under the shadow.
All the days of our life, that when we have served thee in our day and generation, we may be received by thee, our Father, having the testimony of a good conscience in the community of thy church, in the communion of thy church, in the confidence of a certain faith, in the comfort of a holy hope, in favor with thee, our God, and in perfect charity with all mankind, through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. We continue singing now while we have those your comfortable for
believe in love.